Hello, my darlings. I'm joking. Ew, disgusting. Anyways. Oh my god, your friend, Ziggy. Hi, hi. Okay. Now we need to finish this goddamn quest. Yeah. How is everyone? What the fuck is this? I need to go to the circus one. Cause, you know, I'm a clown. I mean, we're all a clown. We just haven't manifest.
There used to be a large stage inside, but after everything got shaken up, it seems the very nature of the entire place was altered.
Altered?
The lamps and crystal light that were hanging above have all fallen down, which makes repairs near impossible.
Hi, Mass!
Wait, so you mean it's difficult to move around in there?
Difficult? This is a big ass place. Why would it be difficult to move around, no?
Yes, mainly because of the lights.
Lights and space is a different thing, no?
Do any of you have experience being on stage? Once the stage lights turn on, everyone's attention is focused on you.
Ooh, nah. Nah, that's the most nightmare I will have, bro.
I can't stand that feeling. Having everyone's attention focused solely on me would just make me feel terrible.
Oh my god. The same bitch.
Me too! I'm no good at speaking in front of people. And then to have everyone staring at you? Oh, just the thought of it makes me
shudder. She's a moon!
Sounds like you have some things you haven't been able to let go of yet.
Please don't laugh. I'm trying my best to change that, but there are still some things I can't overcome. Like when there's a lot of people around, or when people are staring at me.
No, there's nothing funny about that. And you know what? It's not a bad thing to care when other people are looking.
So true.
That's my opinion anyway. Think about it. Only people who have high standards for themselves would worry about failing to meet others' expectations. You have many good qualities, Kale. I bet if you had to learn dance since childhood like myself, then you'd be an even better dancer than me.
No way! That would be impossible.
I can relate. I know exactly how she feels.
Maybe we should find a time for you to learn with me. And one day, you will become an outstanding dancer, too. By that time, you'll be so focused on performing your beautiful moves that you'll no longer worry about an audience watching you.
Wow. You are so passionate about this that she's practically glowing now.
She's glowing. She's glowing.
Really? You do that? You wouldn't think I look stupid and secretly laugh at me, would you?
That's a childhood trauma, Carly. That is childhood trauma.
You really think I'm that kind of person? Fine. Vengeance will be mine.
Oh, no. Of course not. Alright. Please teach me.
Thank you for the lurk.
Seems there's no need for me to warn you again.
Vengeance,
anyway, you just need to open
nuts.
The curtain and you'll be able to see the stage.
Vengeance. It's okay, I didn't read at all. What are we gonna do? Oh, rotate the lamp. I'm rotate. Oh! Then what? I go inside?
What's that thing in the middle there?
That's my crystal light. It's been locked up.
Well, let's figure out a way to fix this. Looks like we need to raise the platform underneath the crystal light.
Crystal light? It looks like an egg, you know, like a bird egg. And you know the inside of it is gonna be a baby clown. Imagine a clown egg. Oh my god. Hi me. What? Huh? What did I say? Install bright brilliant lamp. What's happening? Go inside. What?
It seems we have to use the colorful.
What did you
say?
Oh my god. Good morning. Good morning. Let me get that brilliant light. Why are we killing slimes now? That doesn't make any sense. Circus is supposed to be fun, not for fights.
Shudder.
Shudder. I have brilliant lamp. Oh shit.
That's one way of shining new light on the problem.
Hey, Maymuna? Do you happen to know someone named Sino?
No, never heard that name before. Why do you ask?
Oh, never mind then. I was just thinking you two would have a lot in common.
Back to the situation at hand. We should probably head into the passageway that opened now.
How do you do a mommy voice, guys? Like a mommy voice? Oh my god. Like, mommy. Sorry, mommy. Oh, fuck. Like, I can't do it.
Hello? Is anyone
I'll
here?
I'll just...
If you can hear
I'm
me,
just gonna turn into British mommy. British mommy.
Lessig Lawrence?
Who is Lessig Lawrence?
Who are you? Who has the audacity to utter my full name?
Her, you fucking fucker.
You sure don't look like you're in any condition to be talking like that.
Mommy voice, yep. Yeah,
he's
like
a member of the Lawrence clan.
Hello, dear.
Even the
you. What are you doing here?
I'm just turning into a British mommy. Hello. For I have forgiven by the gods almighty.
Have you come here to mock me, Eula?
If you would just think for a moment, it should be pretty obvious why we are here. Yet, now you're intentionally trying to provoke me?
Oh.
Of course, you don't have to accept my help. After all, aristocrats are naturally superior and need no help from others.
Yes, thanks for the reminder. I don't need help from the likes of you.
I don't think he really means it, Eula. His tone was harsh, but he keeps glancing at you from the corner of his eyes. It's my opinion as a healer that he needs help.
Okay. He's been trapped for so long that it seems he's forgotten how to hold a decent conversation. How ridiculous. Let's go.
Let's
we'll leave the stage to this person who'd rather save face
oh,
than
Eula,
save his own life.
Eula is a Himedere. Himedere.
Hey, no, wait! Halt! You cannot just leave me here. We're both of the Lawrence bloodline, after all. Helping me when necessary certainly won't tarnish your prestige.
Need to maintain lower pitch voice like this.
My predicament will be overshadowed by your virtuous deed.
Am I mommy now?
We must uphold the prestige and dignity of the family.
This is the best reason you could come up with? You think tacking on the word family will be enough to talk me into helping you?
That deep. Okay.
You should be ashamed for your careless actions. It's because of you that we all had to come here.
Seems everyone in the Lawrence clan is this way. They'll do anything to save face.
Even though Eula Sunshine did come all the way here to save him. Did we?
All right. Looks like it's time for the mascot to step in. Here you go. One for Eula. And one for Lessig.
What's that?
What is this? Candy?
Candy.
Thanks.
Oh, the smell. It's just like the aroma I smelled coming from the lens.
Yes, that's right. Enjoying something sweet always lightens the mood.
So true.
Oh, thank you, Miss Mascot. I certainly do feel much better now.
So he's willing to thank someone else, but not me.
Eula has been worrying about you the past few days, and asked me several times regarding how to find you. But now that you two have been reunited, I won't have to keep answering her questions anymore! Oh, I'm so happy!
Mama.
Let me clarify one thing. I don't care what happens to him. If you're going to keep saying nonsense like this, then
Eula will never admit that she actually cares about him.
Yeah, you're probably right.
If you're going to keep saying nonsense like this, then... then at least give me another piece of candy.
Hmm? Oh, sure.
Sorry. I admit my mistake. I know I've caused heaps of trouble for all of you.
Why couldn't you have just said that earlier?
Bro.
Oh? Have you already finished catching up? Why are you all looking at me?
Nothing. Don't mind us.
All right. Then let's clean things up here and keep working our way toward getting the crystal light fixed. Ah, there's no need to push yourself in your condition, Lessig.
I'll take him and find some place for him to rest. I happen to be a little tired myself.
Oh my gosh.
All right. I'll leave my cousin to you then. You'd better rest up and regain your strength before we settle things, Lessig.
Lessig? Okay, do we climb? Climb. What? Oh. Oh, this is a domain, right?
If there's any way to keep raising the platform higher, we probably will need to find a mechanism that's like a lamp.
I still need one more lamp. Oh, okay. No! How do I go back? Hey, how do I go back? Okay. There are stairs for me to climb. Go up. Okay. No. I need to be careful this time.
Strange. Is that really the Lessig that I know?
You shouldn't always judge people based on the way you knew them before. People change, and people can always make different choices.
Oh, look! There's a water droplet over there!
Oh.
A Hydro-Eidolon. It must have been trapped in the curtain. But at least it seems to be okay.
Yippee! We save a water droplet. Ooh! There's another here. Wait. Okay. What is this? Okay. Wait, this is a bit strange. Why does it turn to black immediately? Like, there we go. Yippee. There you go. I did it. Na 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 na. I did it. Bum bum.
A magical tent, after all.
Oh yeah, my friend appears from the outside. It's not really my closest friend, but my friend tried Genshin for the very first time yesterday, and now he's addicted. And he wants my guide. He's still at AR13, so that's fun. Wait, unlock and raise the crystal light. Okay. Oh, there's a ladder. Oh, I see. Okay, I'm going up. Papa. Oh.
Oh, another path has appeared. This should be the last level.
I hope so. I do hope so.
Don't worry. We're almost to the top of the tent.
Wait, we're going to the top of the tent.
The last thing we need to do is raise the crystal light to the very top of the tent. After the stage collapsed, I realized that having it raised only halfway makes it look a lot like the stage at the Grand Bazaar. Have any of you visited the Grand Bazaar before?
Where's Grand Bazaar?
No, I haven't.
I have. I've gone there a few times with Master Tainari. The place is bustling with all kinds of vendors. And if you're lucky, you can see Nilu.
Oh, that Grand Bazaar. I see.
A dance from Sumeru? I'd like to see that myself. If only it were on the way back, then we could stop there.
It doesn't matter if it's on the way or not. I would be happy to take you whenever you have time, Eula.
Oh, that's so sweet.
Great. I'll take you up on that offer.
I've been to the Grand Bazaar. Bazaar. Yeah.
Now that Paimon thinks about it, we've already been there more times than Paimon can remember.
Mm-hmm.
Really? My father used to help with festivities at the Grand Bazaar and would always give me candy during the events.
Aww. Now I want candy.
I was just a kid and didn't understand anything. I was happy as long as he gave me some candy. To me, fairs and festivals were the best things ever.
So a lot of them are from the outside world, and now they are... They live there now.
I always thought my
they
father
practically
was amazing.
Live
I wanted to be just like him when I grew
in
up.
In a bottle. Okay.
But aren't you a scholar in the academia, Mimuna? As far as I know, scholars seldom could spend time doing anything but research. I doubt you could have time to assist your father in preparing festivities.
Why are you being mean? Why are you being mean right now? Why?
Sure. Seems you read me like a book.
Oh. Okay, maybe she's right.
When I had the choice between becoming who I wanted to be and who my parents wanted me to be, I ended up choosing the latter. But I was never happy about it.
BRB feeding my cat. Okay. Thank you for the hydrant.
Huh. That's almost the exact opposite of Eula's situation.
You must have already realized that. Why else would you set up all the booths here and make this place like a fairgrounds?
Yes, but I'm still not as happy as I imagined I would be. I realized that attending a fair and running a fair are two completely different things. The main reason my childhood was so fun and carefree is because my family worked hard.
Aww.
But my father knew how difficult and tiring running a fair could be, so he wanted to push me towards academics.
Academics sucks. It sucks ass.
But in the end, I didn't do well in either. I gave up on myself and resorted to investigating ley lines in the desert. Some things happened and then I accidentally ended up here. I finally had a chance to make my wish of running a fair come true. But after seeing everything come crashing down, I feel like I've lost the strength to go on.
It's not as bad as you make it out to be, Mimuna. No need to feel so down. You have the courage to change, and you've been actively guiding us on this journey.
Yeah. Or what if she's the villain? Oh no.
Someone who's given up on themselves could never do these things.
Okay. You keep saying you're shy, but you're so confident, girlie. Sana all.
I understand my situation better than anyone. You don't need to try to comfort me.
Wow, just be thankful, okay? You have the worst in life, so, you know, people are starting to, like, just what Kali says. Why are you so ungrateful?
It's not that I'm trying to comfort you. It's just that people sometimes don't realize that their actions speak louder than words.
Oh.
Believe me. This is something that I learned from my time together with Eula.
Oh, what are you trying to say?
Hey, yo!
nothing. Now, let's get that crystal light fixed.
Bombastic side-eye. Criminal fan side-eye. What the heck?
All right.
Where's the crystal light? Oh. Ah, okay. Let me pick up this too. But there's another one. But that's just going below, if I have- wait, how do you go there? Oh wait, there's the water droplet thingy. Oh. Oh hi, Lumpia! Hi. Good morning. Good morning. Do I rotate the lamp? Oh! How's the Genshin? I just started, so I really don't know. There we go, okay. Now I can use this. It needs so much. What's this called? Brain cells? I was supposed to stream at 6 PM, but I was like, you know what? I'll do it now. So I've never seen this part of Genshin. Where is this? It's an event.
The lens is made of materials that are easily melted by light.
Is it me, or do I smell something sweet here?
Yeah, it's an event.
Good. That should do it.
Oh! Wow! Wow! That's so pretty! It's like an Easter egg. I like that. That looks so pretty. Easter. Shut up, Mass! Oh my god! Oh! Wait, it's so pretty!
Hey, Idea! We're back!
Oh, I was starting to wonder what was taking you so long. But I'm pretty good at taking care of people. Seems I found another
thing. I've been logging Genshin for a long time, yeah. I mean, I just got back again to Genshin because there was an event.
should be worried for him or happy for her?
The shadow. It's massive. Wait. Shadow just now, it's...
Seems he still might need a little more time to recover. Tell me, did everything go well for you?
It's massive, I know. It's really massive.
Of course.
My memory space it's suffering right now.
They're at least 40 times more reliable.
Only 40 times more reliable?
I guess it's impossible to feel like you've lost once you've already given up. I'm a little concerned about how comfortable you are with that.
Huh? What has happened? How did I get outside of the tent? Ah, that's right. I remember meeting you, La. And then...
Oh, you're awake now. Don't worry. That's just a side effect of your treatment, Lessig.
I'm afraid I still feel a little disoriented.
I'm scared to ask what kind of treatment. Hey, I go look for an Habanashi man gonna eat breakfast. Okay, thank you for the 10 minutes too. Eat well.
Lessig Lawrence.
Oh, it's you, Eula. All right, I'll do it. I'll come back to Mondstadt with you and abandon my wild efforts to restore the Lawrence clan.
Oh, so he's the one restored.
Interesting. Now you want to talk. Seems like you've had a change of heart. In that case, maybe you'll be able to explain everything in detail for us now.
I admit it. Yes. I came here in hopes of finding a way to restore the Lawrence clan to its former glory.
Eula was finding him.
But it was a long journey, and I didn't always know the way. I passed through Liyue and Sumeru. There was even a time when I lost my wallet and had to live in the wild. But the peculiar thing is, I realized that nobody knew me out there. And not a single person even cared about the Lawrence clan. You and I are like glass pawns that were raised in shackles. We were taught to
not
act
with
like
your
nobles,
big ass words. When you're this dumb. Oh my god.
People of Mondstadt despised us. Such pompous, hateful, and stubborn teaching. It all culminated to making us cling to the old aristocratic dogma in an attempt to maintain our pride.
Dogma. Dogma's a word?
It's like a never-ending game of tug of war. But it is meaningless. You understand. Or I should say, you have already long understood. But I'm afraid that I have only just realized this.
Paimon sorta understands what Lessig is saying.
Everything he said is true. Your family is probably unaware that you've already changed how you see things.
Yes. This has all happened recently. After coming to this domain, I realized the Mondstadt that I want is one where not everyone fears me.
Yeah.
All that I and many other members of the Lawrence clan long for is a place where we can live peacefully with others.
Oh my god. Isn't that basic sense?
Lessig, both you and I never had anything to do with the glory of the Lawrence clan. That is all in the past. We are just ordinary people.
We're all ordinary guys. No one special, and I mean, kind of.
I originally planned on returning to Mondstadt after taking care of things here. I never thought you would come here. I was completely shocked, which is why I reacted like I did. I'm sorry.
See, people can always make different choices, and it seems that Lessig has also chosen to become someone he truly wants to be.
Aww.
Yes, about that. I'm afraid I haven't quite found my own purpose in life yet.
Our purpose is to die.
That's all right. Being able to clearly choose between becoming who you want to be and who your parents wanted you to be is already a step in the right direction. How to find true happiness is probably one of the most difficult research topics of all.
I have a suggestion for you, Lessig. Why don't you return to Mondstadt and tell your parents what you just told us?
They'll probably try to tear me limb from limb. But what about you? Did you ever tell your family about what you think?
This is something that I've been thinking about, too. Perhaps the two of us can sit down with the rest of the clan and discuss it with them.
Aww.
The Lawrence clan is just like this stage. It was once home to glorious performances, but those days are now long gone. And it is time for the stage to be updated.
She's so solid and tough, but also...
Oh my gosh, is this like a Kole ex Eula kind of thing? Like...
any time and anywhere she wishes?
Oh my god, there's attention. I'm sensing attention. Oh, hi, baby.
Are you all done talking now?
Yes, I think so. By the way, that is for you. Please take it. I found it on Lessig earlier.
Is that a butt plug?
Oh, it's one of the missing components. Wait. So you had it all this time? Why didn't you give it to me earlier?
Well, you didn't ask. All right, I admit it. I forgot about it.
Okay, we'll let the Traveler hold on to it for now.
Hmm? Wait, this looks like...
a butt plug!
It looks pretty familiar. Have we seen one of these before?
I sense some gay touchability to you, like, I know. Like, I thought it was Kole and Amber, but look at this shit. It's a candy box.
Right. I also bought a similar box at the last festival.
Yes, people often use this kind of box for candy at festivals. This was one of the materials originally used to create the tent. But now that the tent has been repaired, we no longer need it. Eating the candy from the box as an adult will never be as delicious as it was when you were a kid. But if you really think about it, there are way more things you can eat as an adult.
Ah, so when it comes down to it, eating candy is sort of like life. It's just another choice.
So, as of now, we've already collected 3 of the missing components.
Oh my god, just one more.
I'm sorry that repairing the tent took so much of everyone's time. You should all head back and have a rest. I'll lead the way.
Oh my gosh. It looks like a... doesn't it look like a butt plug? It looks like to me. Alright. We got a Amimir. Kokumi.
Hey Kokumi, you're already here!
Oh, you're back. I trust your adventures to the forest went smoothly.
Yep, you could say that. How about you? Up to anything today?
Well... I suppose it's time I told you that, as the Divine Priestess of Watatsumi Island, I shouldn't actually be here now. The truth is that a relic known as the Shinro Casket was lost from Watatsumi Island long ago. But recently, an orb matching the relic's description suddenly began emitting light, almost as if it was guiding people to it. This is what led me to find the relic's whereabouts.
That's what you meant by broadening your horizon?
I wasn't lying when I said that. Koro has often told me that sitting at home reading light novels is not the best of practices, and that I should try to get out more. As I made my way from Watatsumi Island to Sumeru, I enjoyed a variety of breathtaking sights. It really is a beautiful nation. I even stayed in the rainforest for several days.
Ooh.
I was surprised to find that the relic had ended up in the desert. I knew it was somewhere here, but I still couldn't pinpoint the exact location. Though I feel that Idea was not intentionally trying to hide anything from us, this domain does have plenty of secrets. I'm sure you've sensed that too.
Nope. This is an unusual place, and the Idea would suddenly become very busy from time to time, plus she knows hours.
Now that you mention it, a lot did happen today.
I see. When you found Lessig, did you also happen to find any clues related to this domain?
No, I don't think so.
I'm afraid that he was caught up in his thoughts and didn't pay attention to his surroundings. Actually, before the world was flipped upside down, this domain didn't look anything like this.
Wait, really?
Hey, everyone! Oh, I hope we're not interrupting your conversation.
It's all right. You two did a lot today.
Her voice so high-pitched.
Sure. That would be perfect.
Turns out Edea has a cooking stove and oven. Seriously, why didn't she mention it earlier?
Oh, so did you make us some moon pies?
Now I'm hungry.
No, I made something called storm crust pie. You should try one, Travel.
And I made some pita pockets. You can try some, Kokomi. It should taste great with tea.
Tea.
Sorry, I should call you General.
Oh, I would be...
By the way, you,
Oh, him. You would never guess, but he's busy over by the oven now.
Whoa, he's a baker? Oh my god. Last part. Oh. Oh. Okay. Am I done? I was like, oh. Oh, so many more. Eight. Okay. Oh my god. It's like I'm complaining on my homeworks, bro. Okay. Eight in the morning. Oh my gosh. Okay, that was a long time. Edea. Who the fuck is that? No. Sorry, hey Zoe. I'm doing my quest as of the moment.
Really? You do that? Oh, but that's too much. I can't.
No, really. It's all right. We want to do everything we can for the domain.
Yes, and to be completely fair, I'm the one who caused this terrible mess in the first place.
You miss your brain.
Hello, you two. Lessig was just telling us what happened.
Perhaps you should allow me to explain. I'm afraid it was I who caused all this trouble in the domain.
Yes, it was Lessig.
To be precise, I saw a most exquisite water orb at the entrance of the domain. It reminded me of an astrolabe my grandfather gave me when I was 7 years old.
Okay, so exact.
I was curious if it could rotate, so I reached out and touched it.
Give me candy.
Little did I know that it was the core of this entire domain. What I mean to say is, I knew something was wrong as soon as the whole place started flipping.
It's not just your fault. I failed in my responsibilities as the caretaker here. Oh, I knew I should have put the core somewhere more secure.
Oh, you mean the big ball of water at the entrance?
Yes, that's the one. Anyway, after giving it some thought, Lessig has offered to perform some more repairs and maintenance to help support the domain. But we were concerned he wouldn't be able to handle it all alone, so Eula and I will also stay here to lend him a hand.
But don't be mistaken. I'm not doing this out of the kindness of my heart like Kale. My job is purely to monitor and ensure that Lessig doesn't cause any more trouble here.
Oh my gosh. We get it. You love your cousin.
Oh! I don't think anyone's buying that anymore, Eula.
Though I do remember that Amber mentioned we should just nod and agree when you act like this.
Hey, yo! What's happening to them?
Right. You better not slack off today, Lessig.
Ah, No, I'll get right to work.
Either way, Lessig is going to be in charge of making lunch for everyone today.
We'll give him a chance to redeem himself.
Yes, I'll do my best. No need to worry.
What was that?
No, I mean, thanks everyone for giving me a chance to redeem myself. I can already feel new strength kindled inside me. Ha ha ha. No, maybe that's just the heat of the oven.
Very good. But you should conserve your strength. Many parts of the domain are still in disrepair, so we have a lot to investigate.
Seems Adia has a little more pep in her step after finding others to help do the work.
Now that you three are situated, we can focus on what the rest of us will be doing today. I'll go gather the others. We should get ready to leave as soon as possible.
Okay. Please make this a short one. Please. Please.
There she goes. At least she seems to be happy.
Maybe this is how it feels to be in charge.
After waiting for a while, you head to the location of Pentacle to get a weekly kai. Okay. Last one. I hope. There's no TP area? What the? It's okay. I can manage. Summer Serendipity. Don't kill. Did not kill. Oh, this one. Okay. What's that ball? Oh yeah, okay, that's a voucher. Okay. Oh, this is my friend. Oh my goodness.
Where are we going now? We're going to retrieve the last missing component. I'm working, Fairy. Is that the director listed on the sign hasn't.
Okay.
No details slips by.
La 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 la.
Yelling in.
Oh, fuck.
A director no. Kind of job.
No.
The one for is named Zosimos.
I don't wanna find.
Zosimos is responsible
this is
for managing the
song.
On stage.
Take back my life,
is responsible for managing the whole realm.
Probably.
Wow. Sounds like Miss Adia must be way busier.
You'd think so, wouldn't you? Care to comment on that at all, Adia?
Ah, maybe someone else can explain. I'm just enjoying taking it easy, as usual.
Yippee. Oh.
The director doesn't get out much. He's almost always cooped up in his treehouse making props or writing scripts. I'm trying to remember now. Where is that treehouse of his?
Huh? You don't remember?
You don't remember?
Hey, don't forget! I'm just the mascot.
I believe it's that way.
Oh.
Though he might prefer to be alone. Given he often has to move stage props, I suspect that he lives near the theater, and having a view of the entire stage would be useful when imagining a production's actual stage flow. So if I were him, I'd probably pick a treehouse over there.
Over
but
there.
How do you know which direction
over
the theater
there.
Is in?
Ah, simple. The overall layout and decorations look more exciting in that direction.
Oh, good point! Why didn't I think of that?
Let's summon our cart on board. I love going here, man. I love the cart thing. It's so fun. Whoosh. Whoosh. Is it here? It's here. Whoa, that's so cool.
Where did that blasted automation mechanism go?
How long are the quests? I don't know.
The standees are here, but where are the female ones? Who's that? Idea?
Yes, Sosimos. Tis I.
What?
How's that for a dramatic entrance?
This is a surprise. I was sure you'd be...
curled up in a fetal position, crying to yourself?
Wow, what a fascinating little creature. Did you just read my mind?
The name's Paimon? And no, Paimon's no mind reader. Just call it an educated guess.
A hypothesis. I learned that from class, guys.
It seems everyone shares a similar opinion about you, Idea.
I knew from the start that a managerial role wasn't for me. But I found my true calling now. As a mascot!
Mascot? Is that a new role? I don't remember casting you for that.
Okay, enough about me. I'm just here to introduce you to some new friends of mine.
New friends of mine.
And that's why we came to see you. Well, do you have the component that fell out of the central hub?
I do. I'm afraid the incident has caused many malfunctions with the stage mechanisms, and I can no longer put on any performances.
Okay, so you're holding the component ransom till we help you fix the mechanisms, huh?
No, till we fix the stage, surely.
I'd have thought he wants us to make some more props, no? Given that some of the standees are missing.
Or maybe the component is broken and we need to fix it.
You're all forgetting that the majority of his work involves writing scripts. I'll wager that he wants us to edit them.
Just let the man speak.
What has gotten into you all? What sort of person do you take me for, The component is safe and sound. I can give it to you now if you'd like. Although I was hoping that maybe you might be willing to... help rescue my show? You're a big group. I have lots of roles to fill. It would really speed up the casting.
A show?
Oh.
That sounds fun. I want to help. Can we?
So far, so good.
Also, truth be told, I've hit a bit of a roadblock in my script and was just thinking about how to move the story forward. And then you all showed up. Suddenly, I got my muse back. I don't know how to explain it, but... something about seeing all of you finally helped me figure out how to continue my script.
Huh? You mean that story you've been stuck on forever? Are you serious?
Yes, really. Just give me a little time, and I'll write it all up. In the meantime, I'll leave things to you, Idea.
Idea? Why do they all have blue hair? Why?
And he's off!
Zosimos has always wanted to write an epic story about a thief and a mage. Apparently, he got the idea from some rumors that were swirling around, but he only got as far as writing the intro before writer's block set in. Why don't you all take some time for yourselves while I see what I can do? We'll reconvene after the director finishes the script.
Okay. Ow.
A director, my friends, is a storyteller. And the key ingredient to every good story is inspiration.
Inspiration?
The moment I laid eyes on General Sangonomiya, inspiration hit me for a brand new character. The heroine was the missing piece of the puzzle. The rest of the story flowed naturally from there, and now it's finished. So please, take a look through your scripts, and we will tell this story together.
Ayo. Even Klee!
Well, is everything clear?
Director Zosimos, how do you pronounce this word?
Let me see. That's sojourn. It means to stay for a while. This is a very cute moment, so let's make sure that comes through in the performance.
Oh, wait! There's another word I don't know here.
It's okay, Klee. We can go through your lines together a few more times after this meeting's over.
That would be most appreciated, Kaya. I had a feeling about you, actually. You seem to know a thing or two about character acting. Tell me, have you acted before?
You're too kind. It's all in the script, really. It just rolls off the tongue.
Oh, you think so? Well, you definitely have a knack for it. I've actually been looking out for someone with your talent.
Hey, yo!
If I make it as a big-time director, then I can see us working together for the long term. Be sure to stay in touch, okay? You and I are gonna go places.
What can I say?
Kaya as an actor.
Great. Fantastic. Now then, please go through your scripts one more time. But don't just read the words. Remember my notes. And really let the character inhabit you. I need to have a look at the stage, so I'll leave you to it. If you need me for anything, I'll be in the big theater right in the center of this area.
Okay.
Wonder what the theaters are like here. Let's go check it out while everyone's still getting ready.
Where is it? Can you climb? Oh, wait, you can climb. Can you? Oh, you can climb here. Oh my god. Water droplet. Oh my gosh, if this was the real shit, I would die. Like, that's a long ladder. I need my teleport waypoint. Where is it? Give it to me. Okay. Wait, is this the theater? Oh, okay, there's a door. Oh!
Where did it go? I put it right here.
Hey, Zosimos! What you up to?
Oh, it's you two, please. Come here. Feast your eyes on this stage. I designed it myself.
It looks great.
So, directors have to design the stage too?
I'm no ordinary director. I take a more holistic approach. Directing, script writing, stage design, I do it all.
Damn!
Sounds like a lot of work. Idea wouldn't be able to handle that kind of job.
Idea has her work cut out for her too, you know. She's my one and only member of the audience. Though she often criticizes my shows.
She has the gall to sit there and criticize you?
Well, she just says what she thinks. You don't know how to write, or this is getting ridiculous. I think it's because I use preprints in a way that she feels goes against what they're intended for. But even though she's my harshest critic, she's also been my biggest supporter in a lot of ways.
Aww.
I guess you could say she's like my agent. I'm very grateful to her. I've always dreamed of being a director, but I've never had the chance until I came here.
So, what did you do before you came here?
Like I said, I dreamed.
Huh?
From a young age, every time I came home after a show, I'd go over the story again and again in my mind. Growing up, my biggest aspiration was to be a director.
Damn, son of all.
Unfortunately, I couldn't offer much beyond my practical skills. So I ended up spending most of my time as a prop designer and doing a bit of set design on the side.
Prop designer.
Don't get me wrong, I do love building the set, but nothing satisfies me more than putting on my very own show.
No wonder you only wrote director on the sign.
Exactly. You're not doing a great job of convincing me that you're not a mind reader. By the way, could I ask you for your help with something? I'm having trouble finding the master script, and I'll need it shortly.
The one you only just finished writing? You lost it already?
Yeah. after I handed... If it's not here...
Oh, shit.
Then it might be in the attic. These are the only two places I've been since I finished writing it. But... I still have some things to do to get the stage ready.
Sure.
No problem.
Okay, we gotta find his script that he lost, bro. What is this? He lost it already. Go to the attic. Is this the attic? Wait, it said higher. Such a strange box. What the? What is this? Oh. Huh? Oh, okay. The center. Yippee!
Take them.
Watching you play games, it makes me want to play it. Play it then. Oh, okay. Damn, he goes here, bro.
Whoa, look at all these books. Now, where's the master script?
Hiya.
Oh, sounds like a water droplet is on the second floor. Let's go have a look.
Gurgle.
Wow, this is a lot of script. Looks like the water droplet has been managing them for the director. Most of them look like works in progress.
Hey, what's up? How you doing?
I was scared for a moment there. What the fuck? I'm like, who this? I don't know anybody who sounds like this. Hi, Argon. Thank you for the hydrant. Bro, I was not in a call even. I even checked my Discord. I'm like, the fuck? I'm in a call? I can't. That scared me too. Okay, well, we're looking for a message script, so...
And it should be the one that's finished! Okay, this is the only script that fits the... Let's go give it to Director Zosimos!
I hope this is the master script. Thank you for the potion. Yeah.
Ah, thank you. That's a huge help. Anyway, the stage is secondary. The performance is what really matters.
You don't sound very confident.
It's true. I realize now that a show, even if you have the same actors performing on the same stage, the performance will be slightly different every time. Those subtle differences are what make each performance special.
You have a point, but I'm not completely convinced.
Okay, one last request. Traveler, you can enter the pre- The truth is that my sets are composed entirely of preprints. First, now of course, preprints are really meant for making objects to furnish the domain. So using objects to create preprints is, strictly speaking, the reverse of what this is intended for. But Edea said that if this is what I really want to do, she's not going to stand in my way.
Bro, I forgot about that. Don't ever play that again. It makes me suffer. It truly does make me suffer.
Ah, so that's what you meant earlier. Okay, well, what do you need us to do?
I'd like the Traveler to go into the preprint set and help move props around during the performance.
So I'm a part of a backstage crew now.
The reason is,
you want to watch the show.
Oh, Paimon gets it now! If you're busy directing, moving the props, and operating all the mechanisms, you never get the chance to watch the show!
Yes. I know that even if it really is a half-baked script, with shoddy writing and moments of sheer ridiculousness, I'd still like to see it for myself.
I'll be licking. Okay, thank you for the lick, Argon. We're more happy to help! I wanna finish this. I wanna finish this, please.
Long, long ago, there was a great thief. He lived in a land where the light did not shine, where all suffered in the darkness.
People call me?
Sorry, Kaya. Directly into the microphone, please. Otherwise your voice'll... you know.
Okay. They call me the Dagger Bandit. But no one sees that I rob the rich and give to the poor. Here in the dark, evildoers run rampant in the shadows, while the good, honest folk stumble blindly on, just trying to find a way through.
What am I supposed to do?
As the bandit brooded, suddenly the world was inexplicably changed as a single star appeared on the horizon and flew across the sky. Traveler, stomp on that movement mechanism in front of you.
Light. A brief flash, yet enough to illuminate the world. If I can find the source of that light, I can shine it into the darkness, and the people will suffer in blindness no longer.
Okay, walk! Are we gonna walk? Oh, so I'm a backstage crew now.
Without a moment to spare, he set off to follow the star's course. All the while, the star kept moving through the sky. Traveler, the star kept moving through the sky.
Yes! I'm trying!
Looks like I have to go through the desert. This could get dangerous.
If everything he'd heard was to be believed, the desert ahead was a no man's land filled with horrors. Worse still, the star had landed in the most difficult to reach location, surrounded by sheer cliffs. But he was determined to press onward.
I've come this far, and I'm not about to turn back now.
Okay.
The Dagger Bandit trekked deep into the desert wasteland. Yet when he finally arrived at his destination, he found not a fallen star, but a young girl, dressed in white.
How strange. I'm positive this is where the star landed. Young lady, do you know where the light has gone?
The girl replied.
Traveler from afar, the light you seek is only a bottled flame. But the flame has now died, and its light is long gone.
I'm just doing...
Bottled flame?
Yes, it was a gift from another.
And so, the girl began to tell the story of how the bottle came into her possession.
Whoa.
The girl hailed from a kingdom that sat atop the waterfalls. But when the reigning dynasty fell and a new one seized power, she and her people fled for their lives. A thick fog began to fill the air.
This is gonna be a long...
And dense thickets tried to block her path. There is a mechanism down there that you can press to retract the thicket board below the stage.
Huh? Oh. Yeah, I'm a back crew, bro. I thought I'm gonna be an actor.
If I had a lamp to guide me through this wretched forest, then I could survive.
With scratches covering her arms and legs, the girl pressed through the pain and made her way forward. The road ahead was arduous, but she was determined to press onward.
I've come this far, and I'm not about to turn back now.
There you go. Walk faster! Oh my god! Finish work, you pee me heading back home now. Okay. How? Drive safe. Drive safe. Faster, girly.
But just as she was drawing near her destination, a huge stretch of thorns and brambles suddenly came into view. Despair set in and began to weigh on her heart.
If only someone could help me, I would give anything in return.
The girl's heartfelt wish in her moment of desperation did not go unheard.
Wait! There's no mechanism for the final thicket!
Ugh, I must have forgotten to check those boards.
According to the story, those thickets should be gone from the stage now, right?
Oh, shit.
Yes, total oversight on my part. Ugh, what a pain.
I can help! Traveler, catch!
Catch what? Oh.
The girl's heartfelt wish did not go unheard, for a Jumpy Dumpty, who was passing by, helped to clear a path.
Oh, thank you, Jumpy Dumpty.
This is so
and
cute,
so
though, like the art style
journey,
and the background
deeper
into
the
and
forest.
Stuff.
But what she found there was not a lamp, but a mage glowing with fire. So, just to clarify, it was supposed to be the mage who helped burn a path through the thicket.
Save it for the end, man!
The mage took pity on the girl and handed her a bottle.
Oh.
Then, the mage began to tell the story of how the bottle came into her possession. The fiery mage had an adventurous spirit and enjoyed taking long journeys. On one such journey, while taking rest in an oasis,
am I just gonna do move the stars?
Crescent-shaped lake.
This
come,
all.
Quick, get in the light.
Coming.
She was an extraordinary mage with the power to grant people their wishes. She turned the bottle.
Oh, that's why
your
outfit was looking like
power.
A mage.
But the only place that it could make wishes come true was inside of the bottle.
Oh, me! Oh, my! Look at this wonderful bottle of mine! It could make a fine toy. But better still, a sojourner's home.
The fiery mage blew into the bottle, allowing it to grant one single wish outside its glass walls.
Oh, am I supposed to blow into it? Whew. Whoa, it lit up!
A flame was kindled within the bottle, and it began to glow a fiery red, just like the mage herself.
Oh, ah, man.
After the mage finished telling her story, she disappeared, leaving only the bottle behind.
A magic bottle that can grant wishes.
This is so dumb. All I do is move the stars.
No one will ever find me again.
And then, the bottle seemed to softly inquire.
I don't know.
The flame in the bottle faded as the girl's single wish was granted, and she found herself in the middle of the desert, far away, where no one could ever find her.
Oh my god!
When the dagger bandit listened to her story, he sighed in disappointment that the flame with the power to grant wishes outside of the bottle had already died.
But this doesn't make sense. If it truly granted my wish, then nobody should have been able to find me here.
Maybe they shouldn't. The desert is difficult and dangerous to navigate. But I was determined to make it, no matter what.
Then take this bottle with you for your trouble. It may be able to grant you your wish, though sadly, only within the confines of the bottle itself.
All I wish for is light.
Honoring the bandit's request, the girl wished for light inside the bottle. And sure enough, it lit up. They found that while the light was only generated within, it could nonetheless shine through the glass and reach anywhere in the outside world.
Ooh.
Even though it doesn't burn as brilliantly as the light that shone before, this is still an extraordinary light. What will you do after I take the bottle?
Ooh.
I don't
can't
know.
Say what behind.
Maybe you should come back with me.
Hello, no I think after this quest I'm gonna
the
answer,
girl accompanied
bro.
The dagger bandit back to the land where the light did not shine. They brought light to that
good
place.
Good morning.
And the darkness was dispersed, and they lived happily ever
yeah.
after.
Yeah. I'm tired of Genshin, bro.
Seems the show went pretty well.
Klee! Oh my god! She's so cute.
This honorary night! Didn't I do great? I felt like I really was the fiery maid.
Wow, great costume, Klee. As soon as Paimon saw your shadow, she thought straight away, what a cute hat.
It really suits you.
Klee loves it. Thanks, Mr. Zosimo. No, I mean, Mr. Director.
Mr. Director? Huh. No one's ever called me that before.
Thank
you, my dear little mage. Thank you so much. Oh, I'm so happy.
Miss Adia said that she tailored it a little bit so it would fit me. But you were the one who designed and made it. You're amazing.
Yeah, that's amazing. And it sounds like Adia did a great job too.
Oh my
it
gosh.
Nothing, really. Just one of
I would love that outfit,
no,
but I don't have Klee.
Moments. Sewing comes in.
Sewing is an art in its own right.
Really? Oh. I'm just going to go for a second.
Ah, she's flustered.
She gets embarrassed so easily.
Idea's a sensitive person and doesn't have a whole lot of self-confidence. I hope all the excitement hasn't brought her to tears. Oh, I'm a little worried.
Don't worry. I'll go make sure she's okay. I'll see
you. Am I done?
So, what did you all think of the play?
Huh? Uh-oh. Time to get serious.
Oh, absolutely. I had the courage to ask, did...
Okay. Hi, Mom will go first.
I will speedrun this.
The beginning was pretty good, but it ran out of steam as the story went on. Paimon could tell that you ran out of inspiration somewhere along. The characters were honestly a little bit ridiculous.
Oh my god.
Paimon didn't get what you were trying to do. The moment anyone started to show any kind of substance, suddenly the scene...
Yes, all very good points, Paimon. I would add that in its attempt to pay tribute to the series A Thousand Nights, all semblance of a coherent was sacrificed.
Miss Idea, what are you doing?
Oh, you know, I return like the tide when people...
Huh. Especially when it has to do with...
Mm-hmm. But there was one thing I liked about it. Just one, mind you. The story had a good ending. You think so? I thought I was...
Idea, could I borrow you for a moment?
Oh, sure. Excuse me for a moment. Back to you, Paimon. Keep up the good criticism.
Okay, in that case, Paimon did have one other complaint.
Let's hear it. Taking criticism on the chin is all part of being a director.
The ending was all wrong. The girl's motives were clear and simple the whole way through. It was kind of jarring when all she had to say was, I don't know. And doesn't anyone else find it weird how her whole community was on the run, but she was only looking out for herself the whole time?
I'm fine. I'm not going to improve without feedback. I also learned a lot this time with the chance to be off stage. To be honest, it was a dream come true.
What a great attitude. You don't seem upset at all by our comments.
I wouldn't say I'm completely unaffected, but you're only speaking the truth.
Aww.
They're all very valid
points. Wish I was like that.
Still, now that Paimon thinks about it, you did finish the script in a bit of a rush. Maybe we are being a little too...
That's perfectly... We all use our imaginations when we're kids, right? I used to play with dolls in my own cardboard cup. Fast forward to now, and in many ways, I'm still... Of course, a director can accomplish nothing without a cast and crew. So on that note, I want you...
Hey, don't mention it! We had a blast.
Okay, here, take this. Your compo...
Oh my god, finally!
That's right. Can you guess the secret? Bingo! You...
That should do the trick. Oh, wait, this...
Oh, shit!
Than I imagine.
Excuse me, everyone. Do you have a moment? Especially you, Zosimos. Idea wants to do a little something for you.
A dream come true?
Yes. She said that as useless as she is, she wants her words, not mine. I have to disagree, though. I have never thought of Idea.
How is this? If everybody is ready, then I'd like to invite tonight's male lead to take the stage. Ta-da!
Ta-da! No!
How is me changing outfits supposed to make the director's day? It's just a prototype costume.
Don't be silly. If I know our director, nothing...
Well then...
Zosimos drew up countless designs and made a few prototypes before landing on this one. It just...
Oh, it's perfect. Idea. Oh. I'm so touched.
Come on, man. I just want to
end
this quest.
Recovered?
Oh, I'm good.
Oh, please, don't mention it. Well, now
can I keep wearing my costume?
Please do, by all means. Both of you.
Yay! Kaya, keep... I agree with our maid.
Sure. I think I can...
Bye-bye, Mr. Director.
Take care, my dear friend.
Okay. Oh my god. We're done! Wait. Bang now. Nah, I thought we're done. I thought we were done. God, that's so... All I'm doing is complaining. But that is A-okay because that is life. Is this I almost died. You know what? I don't care. Oh, it's even there. Okay. All's good and swell.
Oh, Eula and Kale! You got back before us!
Yes. Idea had the water droplets and...
How is Lissig? Did we finish all the maintenance work? But it...
Oh. Consider it his atonement. It's...
If you say so.
Isn't this where we first...
Correct! The core of the Valyrian Mirage is the largest streaming projector.
Whoa, so... Everything we... So, to fix it, same process as usual.
Exactly!
It's hard to forget after doing it, so...
Let's get going!
Yay!
Finally!
I'm really excited!
The hub consists of these components. All you need to do is place them onto the foundation in the right shape.
The right shape? But we've never seen what it looks like.
Oh, don't worry about it. Close enough will do. As long as it can spin, it'll be fine.
Place lower. Okay, how about this? Done?
We did it!
Oh!
But why isn't it turning? The components are back in the core, and the hub is restored to its proper shape again. That's all we needed to do. Like any wound, it just needs time.
Really? I thought that with your special abilities...
What?
Huh?
Huh?
All of us are dying to see it. Not just how the domain looks when it's fixed, but also Idea. In her element.
I want to see Idea using her magic powers.
Wait,
too.
Really?
What are you guys talking about? And how is Klein on this, but Paimon isn't?
Bro, we're Paimon. That's a we are Paimon. I can't. Haven't you noticed Paimon?
They're referring to our mascot's true form.
As I've said all along, there's much more to Idea than she gives herself credit for. She has a very.
Did you notice right away, General?
So our general was the first to notice. It seems like she's more perceptive than she lets on.
I'd say the same about you.
What the? All of you? No? I mean, I wasn't trying to hide anything from you. It's just... For people who stumble upon this place by accident, I think my current form is more approachable than my true one. I don't want people to get scared when they see me.
I figured.
What is it? And whatever it is, how the heck does everyone know about it?
Well, for one thing, then my mind started to wander as I was reading a storybook, and suddenly, I had a thought. Since Hydro-Eidolons can change into any form, why not human form?
You hit the nail on the head. All right, in that case...
Oh my!
I am an Oceanid who was exiled here when the former Hydro Archon passed away. My name is Idea.
Hey, yo! An ocean?
Wow, Idea! You're so pretty!
Now that I'm in my true form, I suddenly feel a little embarrassed talking to you all.
You look stunning. You should be flaunting this look at every opportunity.
So does this mean that all the people we met in here are actually...
I'm guessing that the human counterparts to these Hydro alter egos are long gone.
That's right. When they want to delete the components are, in fact, gifts that they... But I'm always curious about what brings people here. So I use...
The power to grant wishes.
Exactly.
It's a truly...
I've just realized something. When the components fell from the core, it was after the components landed where they did that their owners and the things associated.
So now that the components have been retrieved. Don't worry, they'll be quite safe. As long as I remember them,
They'll never disappear. However much we might criticize each other or get into scuffles, in this mirage, they will always be my friends.
I had so much fun in the choo-choo cart and hanging out.
Me neither. I'll always...
Very good.
This one's all yours, Adia.
Oh, so the mascot really fits her then? Huh?
Huh?
Huh? No.
Someone get me a bottle. I'm hiding myself.
You're already in a bottle.
What now? This was the only way. Now I'll never be able to show you how the Valyria Mirage is supposed to... Yes, General Sangonomiya? I'm all ears.
If it's okay with you, would you let me borrow the Shinro casket from the Domain's core?
Ah, the Shinro casket. Here.
What is that?
It's the relic that Kokomi mentioned earlier!
What?
It was once a ritual vessel used for making offerings in the Moon Shrine. It's made from the remains of Yokai. Several centuries ago, the relic was lost when the last priest... The pearl that goes with it should be able to sense the casket's location. But... Huh?
Well, imagine it was a sound instead of light.
Oh! I
understand now, too. The core...
Sounds like just my treasure compasses.
Get back to the story. Without the offerings at the yet countless people who have visited this domain brought their wishes with them and left a small...
Wow! I never knew that...
It is powerful enough to help you repair the Valyria Mirage with any luck.
But what do I do with it?
It's simple. We just need to awaken it by telling it what we wish for. For example... My name is Sangonomiya Kokomi, the Divine Priestess of Watatsumi Island, and my wish is to use my critical thinking and strategic planning skills to bring a little more joy into the lives of my fellow Watatsumi
Islanders,
as well as the lives of everyone I cherish. Itia?
Me? My wish is that all those who have sojourned to the Valyria Mirage in the past will achieve what they truly wish for. Not just in this domain, but out there too. Even though I know full well that...
Oh, what the fuck? I'm in a really cool moment here.
And I know
that Miko, Hatsune... Why did I say Hatsune Miko?
It's going to be tough for him.
Wait, what's her name again? I forgot.
Dreams is hard work. Despite all of that, I still hope that somehow, someday... They will achieve their dreams.
Oh my god! Oceanus?
Okay. The combined power of our hopes and dreams is at your disposal.
Yeah, it's an Oceanid.
Thank you.
bestie. Hello. I remember back then she was running away.
Come on, hurry.
What? Oh my god. I love her. She's my Oshino. She's my Oshino, bro.
Yay! Dia, you're back to normal.
Are you Kaya Wolf? Are you
Everyone's
all right?
Praise and curious questions went to my head. I said so many things I'm so ashamed of, and I lost.
Please don't say that.
Yeah. And you weren't Grant. I have friends like that too. Other people's hopes and dreams are what motive, if you ask me.
How many
That's
characters
one of the most
like
noble
her.
Things a person
I don't know.
Can aspire to.
I'm like now, okay.
Please, no more praise. I'm really not comfortable with it. It makes me feel so ashamed. Someone like me doesn't deserve so many people's praise. It's like I'm dreaming.
Well, at least the domain is fixed now. And all the components are back in place.
What's the matter, Clay?
I suddenly have loads and loads of more wishes. I want to ride the choo-choo car again and look down from up on top.
There one in Samara look like her? Yeah, there is.
Is there a way to get up on top?
There is a way, but there's only space for a very few people.
That's okay. I can go up by myself. But it'd be more fun with Miss Honorary.
Aw, I shall not leave your side, my lady.
Are we sure about what happens if we fall off?
I thought you could fly.
Yeah, but...
Paimon's... Don't worry. I'll be there to make sure no one falls off. I haven't been up there in a long time myself.
How can I go there, bro? Imagine if they make really hot and playable, and I know, right? I think it would, a lot of people would cry. Oh wait, shit. Stamina! How can I go up there, man? I thought you were checking her panties. What the fuck? I was climbing. Oh my gosh.
Take them.
Just 10? What is that? What is... Ah, okay. I say now. Okay, I see now. Faster, twirl faster. If I fall here, it's gonna be... Shit. What's a central hub?
Idea, next time you need to bring Kaya and the others up here.
Oh my sure gosh. Thing. Holy shit. Oh.
In
inactivity serves
oh
no-
Oh my gosh.
Whenever people have to leave this domain, I like to come up here and spend some time alone after I've seen them out. They're always overjoyed when they first arrive, but once they realize that they can't take anything home with them, they get upset. Some of them can't bear to leave. Others regret ever setting foot in this place.
Do you ever get sad, Idea?
I feel lonely at times, but not sad. A lot of people destroy everything they created before leaving. But before they left, they asked me to make replicas of themselves using hydro-eidolons. Then they tasked these replicas with maintaining everything they built here. As if this was their way of keeping their dreams alive.
Oh.
Yeah. I don't know how they're faring in the outside world, but just the thought that one day they might achieve their dreams and live on the outside just
it's like
as their
the
counterparts
Lulu.
Doing here.
If you stay
that's
here.
Enough to make me happy. It feels like I'm here waiting for them in the future, where they've achieved everything
you're
they
so
want.
Nice.
I just think that every dream, whether someone is still working towards their dream, as long as whenever they think back to that...
Well, I feel...
then I guess I finally paid Alice back after all these years. Funny to think I've been in the middle of a desert this whole time.
Time for Paimon to give you a nickname!
Mud Fairy.
Mud Fairy! Watch out for Idea!
How dare you mock me! Roar! I'll gobble you up in one mouthful! I'm still embarrassed to have shown you my uglier side. But
no,
I'm glad
it was
the
so
Valerian
pretty.
Mirage is up and running again. This place
well,
is going
to
be
have
bustling
some
with activity.
To
yep.
I want to get everyone together for one last run.
No! Oh, okay. Yippee! Okay, I'm finally done with this shit. Yippee. Okay. Now that we're done, fuck this game. now we're done. Thank you everyone who came in for this short ass stream. And I think I'll do am I doing just chatting tomorrow? No. Bro, Twitter and his and their X fucking logo. Yeah, I think I'm going to chatting tomorrow. Now League. No! I hate League. No, I love League. I love League. Okay. Twitter's X shit something. You know? But let's raid. Sorry, bestie. I'm not. Okay. Let's raid. When can I be in Sen Circle? Twitter Circle? Nah, you don't wanna be there, bro. It's all like depression. You wanna be there? I'll try. Okay. You wanna my depression? yeah, okay. I will go now, but sure some. I will. Okay, bye. Don't do it a lot. Bye. Bye. Bye.